Good morning.
Morning.
Welcome to worship. It's so nice to see you here today. Oftentimes people talk about Christmas being all about giving. But I have to tell you that in my house, I've been teaching my children that Christmas is all about receiving. It's all about getting. Does that sound wrong? Does that sound selfish? Maybe a little, but not when you understand the context. Christmas is all about us receiving our Savior from sin. We who were poor spiritual beggars who have nothing to offer, nothing to give our God that hasn't been soiled by sin, we get forgiveness and cleansing in our Savior, Jesus Christ. That's why Christmas is really all about receiving, not the gifts that we're giving to each other back and forth under the tree. Not what's waiting, that we're waiting to open up, or what we're getting in our stockings. It's about what we got in the stable. It's about the fact that we have received our Savior. In that sense, Christmas is all about receiving. May God bless our worship here today as we receive His Word in our children's service. We'll begin with our processional hymn, "Come Hither, Ye Children." That we are unworthy of the gifts God has given us. Forgive us, Lord, for our selfishness in this season of giving. Forgive me for forgetting that it is all about you and not me. We do not deserve all you have given to us. Romans 6:23 tells us, "For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord." In Him we have redemption through His blood, the forgiveness of sins, in accordance with the riches of God's grace that He lavished on us with all wisdom and understanding.
Thanks be to God for His indescribable gift.
You may be seated.
Tradition gifted at Christmas time.
Some people exchange gifts on Christmas Eve, some wait till Christmas Day.
Countries around the world have different customs surrounding the Christmas holiday.
Some people don't give gifts until a celebration of Epiphany, coming out of Wise Men on January 6th.
No matter when you exchange gifts, it may be hard to wait for them.
God's people long ago were promised a Savior. Adam and Eve were told of the Savior's coming. Genesis chapter 3, verse 15 tells us that Jesus will win over Satan.
Generations later, Abraham was told of the Messiah's coming.
In Genesis 12, verse 3, Abraham is promised that all peoples on earth will be blessed through you.
In Psalm 89, verses 3 and 4, we read that God will establish and keep his line forever and make his throne firm through all generations because Jesus would be born through the line of David. The children of Israel anticipated the gift.
Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6 says, For as to a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders.
And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Even though they still waited for the gift, they had a sure and certain hope that they would indeed receive their Emmanuel.
Galilee, to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house of Mary.
He went there with Mary to be blessed, to be married to him, expecting a child.
While they were there, the time came for a baby to be born. She gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in the manger. There's no room for them in the inn. Broken flesh.
We have seen the glory of the one and only who came from the Father, full of grace and the truth.
At night.
angel of the Lord appeared to them, and they, the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. While they were there, the time came up. But the angel said to them, "Be not afraid, I will bring you good news of joy. There will be for all the people. Today, in the time of days, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord."
Whoa!
This will be a sign to you. You're a family baby, wrapped in cloth and lying in the manger.
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying,
"Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests."
So, let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about.
So they hurried off to find Mary and Joseph.
So they hurried off to find Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger.
Thank you. And smiling faces and happy hellos this evening. For the Bible says, rejoice in the Lord always. Again I will say rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to all. The Lord is near. Philippians 4:4-5.
Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day to save us.
Every birthday
gift is
When shopping for gifts, it is sometimes difficult to find something for everyone on our list, but there is truly a gift where one size fits all.
You are all sons of God who are in Christ Jesus. For all of you who have baptized yourself into Christ have clothed yourself with Christ. There is neither Jew nor Greek, slave nor free, male nor woman, for you are all one in Christ Jesus.
Through baptism, we have all received the gift of being a child of God.
By washing of regeneration and renewal by the Holy Spirit.
Every time we wash our hands, take a bath, and drink a glass of water, we remind you of the precious gift of baptism, where we are brought into God's family through water and word.
And being part of God's family is a very special gift.
You are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people belonging to God,
that you may declare the praises of Him who called you out of the darkness into His wonderful light. 1 Peter 2:9.
Before God is strong, before our
Every perfect gift is from above.
When we receive a gift, it can be frustrating when the gift has the dreaded words "assembly required" on the package. Another disappointing moment may be getting an awesome electronic toy, only to discover no batteries included. Fortunately, our next gift requires no batteries or assembly.
But because of His great love for us, God, who is rich in mercy, made us alive in Christ, even when we were dead in our transgressions. By grace, we have been saved.
We are reminded of this, especially when we hear the words of institution spoken by Christ.
While they were eating, Jesus took bread, gave thanks, and broke it, giving it to His disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body."
Then He took the cup, gave thanks, and offered it to them, saying, "Drink from it, all of you. This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for the forgiveness of sins."
Mr. Lott is going to start.
is one gift and will never have to return, the gift of eternal life.
Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
In his great mercy, he has given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, an eternal inheritance that can never perish, spoil, or fade, kept in heaven for you.
I give them eternal life, they shall never perish, nor will snatch them out of my hands.
The second person is joy. The third person is praying to God's family. The fourth person is forgiveness. And the fifth person, eternal life.
Thank you.
we have received these precious gifts, how do we respond? People in the Bible show us what to do.
As the birth of Jesus, Mary responded by treasuring the gift of the Christ child.
Mary treasured all these things and pondered them in her heart.
Like Mary, we should respond to the gifts of Jesus by taking time to reflect on our Savior and the gifts he has given us.
The wise men, too, show us how we should respond to the gift of Jesus.
On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary and bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts, gold and of incense and of myrrh.
Like the wise men, we come to the house of the Lord to worship him. And we honor Christ by giving gifts to others this Christmas and giving of ourselves to his glory.
We offer Jesus a portion of what he has given us as a way of saying thank you to him for all of his blessings.
In addition, we would like to thank each of you for the gift you are to each of us. So during the offering, we will have a reverse offering of sorts.
Please take the prayer cards with you that the children will be handing out and join us in the song as we take the offering at this time.
Thank you. Our final response is to tell others about Jesus.
Shepherd shows how we should respond to the gift of Jesus by going and telling people about him.
Luke 2:17-18. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child.
And all who had heard it were amazed at what the shepherd said to them.
Of Christmas, dear Father, when we think about the gifts under our tree and the gifts that need wrapping and the gifts we will rip open on Christmas Day, help us, dear Lord, to remember that it is the giver that we should cherish most, not the earthly gifts. And you are that giver. And to you we give our utmost thanks. For as it says in James 1:17, every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of the heavenly lights. So thank you, Father of the heavenly lights, for every perfect gift. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated for our recessional hymn, Every Good and Perfect Gift.
Amen.
Good morning once again. Welcome to worship. And what a wonderful message that the children got to share with us today. That the real story of Christmas is all about what we receive. I told you, Christmas is all about receiving, not giving. And that's not to sound selfish, but we can be selfish about the fact that we do have our Savior and we do have our forgiveness. He gave that to you and to me. A couple things just to point out. I made a mistake in the bulletin. Christmas Eve is not on Friday. It's on Saturday. So don't come here on Christmas Eve. Otherwise, you'll be here by yourself. But please come to our Christmas Eve candlelight service on Saturday at 7. We'd love to have you there for that. We also will be having an 11 o'clock Christmas Day service. So we'd love to have you for that as well. And an 11 o'clock New Year's Day service. So on the 25th and on the 1st, you're just going to be having coffee with me if you show up for first service. So it's just the 11 o'clock service. No Bible class, no Sunday school for the next 2 weeks. But please, please come. If you're traveling this upcoming Christmas and you won't be able to be with us, I wish you God's richest blessings as you celebrate, and may He send His holy angels to keep you safe and lead you back safely to us. The rest of the announcements I'll let you read in the bulletin on your own. I'm going to dismiss you and let you out, and we thank you so much for coming. So God's richest blessings. Thank you. Thanks for your work. Thanks for your work. Good morning, thanks for your word.
I kept saying, wait till